You've heard the term, say it, don't spray it? Well, research shows you may be spreading germs even if you're not a sprayer when you talk.
When you see a cough or a sneeze, you see a little spray of droplets. When you speak, you also emit respiratory particles, but they're way too small for the human eye to see. But they're still huge compared to a virus.
UC Davis professor William Ristenpart has studied airborne disease transmission for years, looking at the role speech plays in spreading the flu. While he didn't study COVID specifically, what he found strongly implies the virus could be transmitted when we talk through particles as small as 1 micron.
When you sneeze or cough, if you can see them, if you can see little droplets, the limit of resolution of the human eye is about 30 microns.
Those droplets, when you sneeze or cough, travel about 6 feet before gravity takes over. That's why it's recommended we stand 6 feet apart. But particles we emit just by talking, they're so small they can float in the air much, much farther.
It looks like you're in your office somewhere. On the other side of your house, presumably, you have a kitchen. If somebody starts baking chocolate chip cookies, eventually you'll smell the aroma, right? And so the question, how do those aroma molecules get there? Nobody had to sit there and cough or sneeze them, you know, across the room. They just got carried by natural currents in the ventilation all the way through your house until they reached your nose and you smell them.
What's still unknown is why some people emit so much more than other people do when they talk. Professor Ristenpart calls them super emitters. And if a super emitter has a virus, they could be a super spreader. Some other things to know. Super emitters come in all shapes and sizes. There's no way of identifying them by sight. But research shows that loud talkers could be emitting more particles. Also, wearing a mask is better than not wearing a mask, but it's not a foolproof solution. In Sacramento, Kristen Samos, KCRA 3 News.